trouble. You need, oh, some love and care. Ain't nothing. I said, ain't nothing. Go. Yeah.
Wow. Yeah. Let me tell you something. Oh, like you in a dead situation. I dare you to make your way right here, now. And say, he'll take care.
Just a child when I had the Savior leading. I was drawn to what I could not understand. For the cause of Christ, I have spent my days believing that what He'd have me be is who I am. As I come to see the weaker side of me, I realize this grace is what I mean. When sin demanded justice for my soul, mercy said no. I'm not gonna let you go. I'm not gonna let you slip away. You don't. Life and death stood face to face. Darkness tried to steal my heart away. Thank you, Jesus. Mercy said no. From the cross He built a bridge to set us free. Oh, but deep within our hearts, there is still a war that rages. He makes a sacrifice so hard to see. As midnight fell on crucifixion day, the seem all so far away. As evil tried to stop redemption's flow, mercy said no. I'm not gonna let you go. I'm not gonna let you slip away. You don't have to be afraid. Mercy said no. Sin will never take control. Life and death stood face to face. Darkness tried.
said the road is long, there are mountains in our way, but yet we'll climb still higher every day.
Lord, lift us up where we belong.
Oh, yeah.
Where the eagles fly on a mountain high. Lord, lift us up where we belong. Yeah. Far from the world we know.
Where the clear winds blow. What it used to be. Stop living your lies looking behind.
'Cause all we have is you right now. And our lives are in you to find.
Oh, but the
you. You are here working in this place. I worship you. I worship you. You are here moving in a mist. I worship you. I worship you. You are here working in this place. I worship you. I worship you. Hey, we make a miracle worker, promise keeper, light in the darkness. My God, that is who you are. Waymaker, miracle worker, promise keeper, light in the darkness. My God, that is who you are. You are here, touching every heart. I worship you. I worship you. I worship you, I worship you. You are here, turning lives around. I worship you, I worship you. You are here, mending every heart. I worship you. I worship you. Hey, we make a miracle worker, promise keeper, light in the darkness. That is who you are. Hey, we make a miracle worker, promise keeper, light in the darkness. My God, that is who you are. You wipe away all tears. You mend the broken heart. You're the answer to it all. Jesus, you wipe away all tears. You mend the broken heart. You're the answer to it. I worship you. You are here meeting every need. I worship you. I worship you. Oh, devotion day, I'm a
I Give up now. I know to cast on.
I will keep you.
Yeah.
person. If you're looking for somebody, he's gone.
Let the family remain seated. Shall we stand? And Jesus said unto her, I am the resurrection and the life. He that believeth in me, though he were dead, yet shall he live. Behold, I show you a mystery. Ye shall not all sleep, but ye shall be changed in the twinkling of an eye. Let not your hearts be troubled. Ye believe in God, believe also in me. In my Father's house are many mansions. If it were not so, I would have told you. I go to prepare a place for you. And if I go and prepare a place for you, I will come again and receive you unto myself, that where I am, there ye may be also.
Let us bow our heads for prayer. Our Father which art in heaven, our Father which art in heaven, hallowed be thy name. Father, we're here today, but you have told us in your word, in 1 Jeremiah, the first part of Jeremiah 1, verse 5, before I formed thee in the belly, I knew thee. You also told us in Psalm 90, verse 12. So teach us to number our days. Father, you've told us also in Psalm 23, verse 4, yea, though I walk through the valley and the shadow of death. Father, today, laying in front of us is someone I call Mr. Shayne. Father God, we can't understand this right now. But Lord, before he was formed in her womb, you knew Shayne. Father God, you numbered his days. He passed at 32, almost 2 days shy of his 33rd birthday. Father, to break those years into days, he lived for 12,051 days. 12,051 days on this earth, dear Father, then on the 12,051st day, you walked him through the valley and the shadow of death. We're trying to make sense of all of this, dear God. So, Father, the family needs healing today. The family needs strength today. The family needs hope today. The family needs comfort today. So, Father God, as we sit in this room today, we pray that as the songs are sang, there will be healing. We pray, dear Father, as the scriptures are read, you will give them strength because you are our strength, dear Father. Father, we pray that as the tributes are presented, it will cause us to reflect. Father, we pray the one who will present the word, you will give us hope today. The one who will present the prayer of consolation will give us comfort. Father, family needs this today. A mother is grieving. There are siblings that are grieving. There are grandparents that are grieving. There are aunts and uncles that are grieving. There are close friends that are grieving. If ever we need you is right now in this sanctuary. So Father, we ask that Shekinah glory will come into this worship service and provide some comfort. And Father, there are those who haven't been in this church for years. Teach us to number our days. Shayne had lived his 12,051 days. We need to number our days. But we know one thing, that there is a blessed hope. And on that great getting up morning, on that great getting up morning, when that shout comes out from the heavens, we pray we will see Brother Shayne going against gravity, and we will be caught up to meet them. So Father, give us this hope as we prepare to celebrate his life today, and we will surely continually walk in your presence for the rest of our lives. In your holy precious name, amen, amen. You may be seated.
When peace like a river attended my way, when sorrows like sea billows roll, whatever my lot, thou hast taught me to say it is well with my soul. It is well. I'm going to ask the church, will you sing with me as we sing this familiar hymn of the church together? When peace like a river attended my way, when sorrows like sea billows roll, whatever my lot, thou hast taught me to say, it is well, it is well with my soul. My sin My sin, not in part, but the whole. Is nailed to the cross, is nailed to the cross, and I bear. that day. And Lord, haste the day when my faith shall be silent, the cloud be rolled back as a scroll. Not only that, but the trump shall resound, and my Lord shall descend. Even so, it is well with my soul. It is well with my soul.
And sisters, clergy, elders, officers, family of the dear deceased. In times like these, words escape us. In times like these, we often ask the question, why? But we are assured today that we serve a sovereign God who is able and capable of receiving and answering our questions. And more than that, he has promised to give us comfort in moments like these. Allow me, on behalf of our pastor, Dr. Nicardo Delahaye, who is unavoidably absent today, the elders, the officers of this dear church, to extend to you, family, our heartfelt and deepest condolences. Shayne was very much a part of us. He grew here at this church. He was intricately involved in every aspect of ministry, and it grieves us deeply. We pain deeply to be even here today. But we know that God is able. I said we know that God is able. He's able to lift those who are downtrodden. He's able to dry every weeping eye. He is able to succor those who come to him in their moment of need and weakness. And wherever there is grieving and mourning, we are assured by Scripture that God's presence is there. So be comforted today. Cry if you must. Weep if you must. We are here to support you as you process this experience. For those who are here at our physical campus, again, we welcome you to faith. We are requesting as much as possible, again, given the pandemic situation we are experiencing, that everyone wear a mask. If you do not have one, one will be provided to you. Our restroom facilities are on the lower area. If you go to the outside, on my left at the bottom of the stairs is the ladies' room. To the right at the bottom of the stairs is the men's room. We look forward to a mighty move of God today as we remember and celebrate the life of this amazing young man. May it give us hope and courage as we proceed through this service. To those who are viewing online, we welcome you, and we pray that God's blessings will also reach you where you are. We are here to remember what God has done through the life, even though it was short, the life of this amazing young man, Shayne Fields. Our service will proceed as it's indicated in the bulletin, except where we may have a few inserts for adjustments. We will announce those as we get to them. But at this time, we are going to be inviting Sister Marion Blake to come forward and render a special musical item.
I've had some good days. I've had some hills to climb. I've had some weary days. All of my good days outweigh my bad days, and I won't complain. Sometimes my clouds hang low, and I could hardly see the road. But I asked the question, Lord, why so much pain? Because been good to me.
To me, so very good to me. Thank you, Sister Marion, for those fitting words of affirmation, trusting in a God who knows and sees the end from the beginning. We praise you, God. We bless you, God. We honor you, God. This time we're going to have our scripture readings, an Old Testament scripture presented by Elder Lenford Clark, followed by a New Testament scripture presented by Sister Audrey Clark. After the reading of the scriptures, we will have a special item of musical praise by the Daughters of Zion. We will have those items in that order.
Good morning, everyone. Shayne, I'm the uncle of Shayne Field. And every time Shayne would see me, he would say, "Hi, Uncle Lenny," or "Hi, Aunt Marcia." And he would give me a hug, and we just talk about good times and so forth. But Shayne had a lot of business deal he had to accomplish, and he did it all. And he's gonna be missed, but Shayne wanted us to move on. He wanted us to move on. And he's gonna be missed by his mother Carol and his siblings them. But he's at peace now, and you know, we just continue to pray for the family and so forth. It's me and my sister is gonna read a scripts from the Bible, and we pray that the family members and each people be comforted by these words. So we thank all you for coming out. It says, "He that dwelleth in the secret place of the Most High shall abide under the shadow of the Almighty. I will say of the Lord, He is my refuge and my fortress. My God, in him will I trust. Surely he will deliver thee from the snare of the fowler and from the nonsense pestilence. He shall cover thee with thy faith feather, and under his wing shall thou trust in him. Thou shalt not be afraid for the terror by night, nor for the arrow that flieth by day, nor for the pestilence that walketh in darkness, nor for the destruction at noon. 1,000 shall fall at the side, and 10,000 at thy right hand, but it shall not come nigh unto thee. Only with thy eye shalt thou behold and see the reward of the wicked. Because thou hast made the Lord, which is my refuge, even the Most High, thy inhabitation. They shall no evil befall thee, neither shall any plague come night on thy dwelling. For he shall give his angel charge over thee to keep thee in all thy ways. They shall bear thee up in thy hands, lest thou dashest thy feet against thy stone. Thou shalt tread upon the lion and the otter. The young lion and the dragon shall thy tramp under thy feet, because he has set his love upon me. Therefore will I deliver him. I will set him on high, because he has known my name. Verse 15. He shall call upon me, and I will answer him. I will be with him in trouble, and I will deliver him and honor him. With love, with long love life, I will sanctify him and show him my salvation. My Lord had his rest upon this word.
Amen. Good morning again, church. My name is Audrey. I am Carol's sister, and Shayne is my nephew. And I will never, ever forget Shayne's smile and his laughter, okay? So let's just continue to pray, and one in God's willing, we'll meet each other again in heaven, especially Shayne. I'll be reading from the book of Romans, chapter 5, verses 1 through 5. And it reads, therefore, being justified by faith, we have peace with God through our Lord Jesus Christ, by whom also we have access by faith into this grace wherein we stand and rejoice in hope of the glory of God. And now only, but we glorify in tribulation also, knowing that tribulation worketh patience, and patience experience, and experience hope. Verse 5, and hope maketh not ashamed, because the love of God is shed abroad in our hearts in the Holy Ghost, which is given unto us. Amen. Let us all say amen. Amen.
Good morning, everyone. We are the Daughters of Zion here at Faith, and as a family, as a group, we need to express our condolences. There's someone in our group who is very dear to our hearts. Actually, Daughters of Zion is our prized child. And to you, Milka, we extend our hearts out to you. We are here with you as a family, and to the entire Clark family, we want to express our condolences. To let you know, as a family, we are in this together with you. And Milka, if it is up to you, we'd like for you to sing with us as we express the celebration of Shayne, knowing and looking up to the blessed hope that there will be one day that we all will cast our crowns at his feet. So Milka, if it's up to you, if not, sit and relax as we praise God together.
Far behind and Sorry, can you get the speakers in front of us working, please? Because we can hardly hear.
Thank you.
Had not been for the Lord who was by my side, where would I be? We will continue with the program as it is outlined. At this time, we are going to be entertaining some tributes from friends. The individuals that will be coming up in that order to the podium just to my left and sharing those tributes will be Armand Caldwell, followed by Shai Graham. Jack Gagne will be a video tribute. John Lee will also be a video tribute. And we also have Stacy who will follow. I stand corrected, moving a little too fast. So first we're doing the tribute from the family. Thank you so much for that. We will start with Sister Milka Daniel. Sister Milka Daniel will come up, followed by Geneva McCullough, Sylvia King. In that order. So those three family tributes at this time. Mm-hmm.
Daniel, and Shayne is my beloved nephew, and I would just like to thank everyone for being here and for supporting my sister and our entire family. We appreciate your love and support so much. It's been such a comfort to us that you have poured out your love and that you have poured out your support, and that you have just surrounded us with so much attention because we need it so much. Shayne, you brought all your boys to church this morning. And they're all dressed in white, and they look so beautiful. And Shayne loved his boys. He had a lot of boys. Shayne, I didn't think that I would be the one to be giving my remarks to you. I thought it would be the other way around. But here I am. I'm speaking to my family and my friends at this time, giving tribute to you. Shayne and I had a special relationship. He would just tell me, he would call me or he would text me, and he would just tell me things that I didn't even want to hear. But he would just call me in his, you know, sometimes he would be at a 10, that's where his volume normally is. He's normally at a 10, but when he's up at 100, I know something is wrong. So, you know, if he was at a 10, you know, I would, you know, oh, hey, Shayne, how you doing? You know, everything is all right. Yeah, auntie, I'm doing good. But when he's at 100, you know, he'd call me, auntie, this is what happened. And, you know, he would just go on, and I'm like, all right, Shayne, you know, calm down. You know, sometimes when I was in his presence and he was, you know, up here, you know, I would just have to just go like this, Shayne, calm down, it'll be okay. So that's the relationship we had, and sometimes he would just text me randomly, or he would just call me randomly, and he'd just say, auntie, I love you. You have a good day, okay? Have a good day. I remember one of the calls, this was one of the distressing calls that he had called me. He had an issue with his vehicle. And he had some other things that were going on, and he just felt like the earth was caving in on him. And I was at work, I work from home, and I was at work, but whenever Shayne called me and he needed something, it didn't matter what I was doing, I would just drop whatever I was doing and I would go to him. That's just how it was. So, you know, I calmed him down on the phone, and he was just in a bad situation. So I said, Shayne, you know that God loves you. You know that God loves you, and you know that I love you. And at one point he said to me, auntie, you know, some of the things that I've done, auntie, if I told you everything that I've done, I don't think you would love me. I said, Shayne, there's nothing that you could ever do There's nothing that you could ever do that would make me love you less. And we cried on the phone, and I said, Shayne, I'm coming to get you. Tell me where you are right now. And I called my manager. I said, I have to go. My nephew needs me. And I went to him. I picked him up. He cried some more. I brought him home. I fed him. Because he would love to, he would call me randomly as well. And he said, Auntie, you have food? And I said, yeah, I have food. I would come and serve him a big plate of food, and I'd serve him his drink, and he would eat it. Oh, Auntie, that is so good. That is so good. So I brought him home, and I fed him, and he ate. And then I said, just go lay down. Just go lay down and just rest. And that's what he did. He laid down, and when he got back up, he was feeling better. He was feeling better. And so that's the relationship we had. He would just call me, and he just knew. He knew that I would come to him. He knew that I would aid him. But Shayne, I couldn't help you this time. I wish I could have helped you this time. I couldn't help you. I couldn't help you this time. I couldn't help you. But God was with you. God was with you. He struggled with you. And he still protected you. Because even when you were in the water, when the Coast Guards called my sister, they told her, you know, Carol, there were four sharks that were right around your boy. Four sharks were around your boy, and they never touched him. They never touched him. So even in the midst of what he was going through, God was still with him. He was still with him. Shayne, I'm going to miss your love. I'm going to miss your hugs. I'm going to miss your kisses. But Shayne, let us meet on the north side of Heaven Avenue so we can just pick up where we left off. We're going to hold on. We're going to carry the fort because you worked a lot. You did so much. You tried so much. We're going to continue for you. We love you. And we're going to keep Shania. We're going to keep Preston. We're going to keep Hope. And we're going to keep them strong. And they're going to be able to grow up to wonderful young women and a young man. We're going to keep your legacy going. We're going to keep your legacy alive. We love you, my boy. We love you. Thank you.
Good afternoon, church. I'm Shayne Cousin. My name is Anne-Marie, and this is my sister, Geneva. I'm here. I'm going to read a letter from my sister to Shayne. They were very close. This is her words to Shayne. I have been in Shayne's life since the day he was born. I babysat him and became very attached to him as if he was my little brother. Shayne always said I was not only his cousin, but I was like a sister to him, and that he trusted me because I listened and never judged him. He would randomly visit me, and from the moment he entered the door, he would say, I love you, Geneva, and say it again when he leaves. No matter how bad things were, I could never get upset at Shayne. He always gave the infectious laugh and smile. He was always comfortable opening up to me, telling me things he was going through or things he had on his mind. Shayne was very smart and always have a business idea or plan on doing something. He would speak with enthusiasm about all his plans and his ideas. And as he's speaking, I can remember him just being in my living room, just walking around, very excited. He just couldn't stay still. I want to say this to my Aunt Carol. I don't know if Shayne shared this with you like he had planned, but my last conversation with Shayne is him telling me that he wanted you to be very proud of him and that he needed to be a man, the man that you raised him to be. He talked about opening his recycling business or doing real estate as a way to build himself up, to make you proud. He just wanted you to be so proud of him. That he loved you, but he fell short in showing you most of the time. My last word to him was, you have to focus on Shayne. Forgive yourself and let the past stay where it belongs, in the past, and that I love him no matter what. And as we all have heard today, over and over, Shayne had a huge heart, a huge smile. You would never see Shayne without him grabbing you and hugging you and kissing you, because that's how loving he was. I'm gonna miss Shayne. I'm gonna miss that smile. I'm just gonna miss everything about him, especially, you know, that bear hug where you can't even breathe because he's taller than you, you know, and just can't breathe. But that's Shayne for you. And we love him and we're gonna miss him. Thank you.
Shayne's grandmother, and I would like the church to please stand. I would like the church to please stand and the congregation. I'm Shayne's grandmother, and I will need some help from the church. That's why I asked you to stand. I'm going to sing what the church say, amen. Will the church say amen? Will the church say amen? God has spoken. Let the church say amen. Let the church say amen. Let the church say God has spoken. Let the church say amen. Let the church say the church say amen. God has spoken. Let the church say amen.
Fitting words of tribute. The memories will live on, and we'll be encouraged by the life and legacy that Shayne left behind. Well, we're going to invite G-Clef to get ready to come now to share their item of musical praise. For those who recall, Shayne was a part of this amazing young men's singing group called G-Clef. We could often hear him peeling his tenor piece out, and we just trust that you will be blessed by the ministry. After G-Clef has rendered their special item of music, we will have tributes from friends as outlined in the program. We will call them up at that time, but G-Clef at this time.
I'm just reminded of when we were getting the group together, I was teaching some of the fellows, the young, they were around 16 then, 15, 16, 17. And our rehearsal room was the bathroom downstairs. I taught them the song Wonderful, which we're gonna attempt to do right now. I remember when I thought they finally got it together, I told them, I said, listen, I'm going to put you guys on next month. Shayne said, which service? 11 o'clock. Shayne said, did you hear what Elder Kitt said? We're going on prime time, prime time. This is prime time for you.
Wonderful, wonderful Jesus,
wonderful,
he's so wonderful,
wonderful
to me,
wonderful, wonderful,
and I'll praise his holy name, 'cause he's so wonderful.
So wonderful.
And oh, Pray to my Father to come down and make a way. 'Cause I know, I know my God. 'Cause He's so wonderful.
Sounds sweet. Wonderful, wonderful. He's so wonderful to me. Bless the name of the Lord. Bless the name of the Lord. Now, we have certain friends who will be coming to share their tributes and their recollections and fondest memories of Shayne. We have Armin Caldwell, who will be followed by Shai Graham. After those two, we will have two video tributes, one by Jack Gagne and another by John Lee. And to close us out with the fifth tribute will be Stacy. If Stacy's not here, I believe there is a family member that may be here that will be sharing that tribute. We'd invite you to come up and share that at this time. So let's begin with Armin Caldwell, followed by Shai.
Like to say just good morning to everybody, and it's a lot of love in here today for a great person. I was asked to do this by a special person and to put a eulogy together for my brother, but I'm not gonna lie, like, it wasn't an easy task because Shayne's a great guy, and I was thinking it had to be important. It had to be a top-notch eulogy from a top-notch speaker, but sorry, Shayne, like, I ended up being one of the people that ended up doing that for you today, but I'm gonna make do for it. And for 18 years, I can say that it's not by blood, but it might as well be, because for 18 years, he's been like a brother to me in the what I would call a true friend, who was always there for me for like through thick and thin. Anything that I was going through, I would call him, and he was always there for advice, to pick me up and stuff like that, and I would do the same for him, and it just continued forever. And we were always on an adventure together somewhere. There's countless memories I'll never forget from us going through 4 telephone poles together, all the way up to owning a recording studio years after. Since kids, it was always like a celebration. Like, when his mom was on vacation, we was kind of on a little vacation ourselves. And Miss Milky used to always save us when we kind of had a hiccup with that. But one of the best moments we had was in New Jersey a few years ago. We went to a party with a friend of ours that we met that used to work with Tesla. And we ended up going to Nikola Tesla's actual house. It was surreal because we were just getting familiar with the company and they gave us firsthand experience with a couple of Nikola Tesla's inventions. It was all worth it until we realized it was 3:30 in the morning and we had exactly 4 hours to get back to Connecticut and get to work. We made it back on time, but I say that to say this. He always tried to live life to the fullest and experience everything he could and learn more and be there for his family and friends. And because of moments like that, I know that he lived life to the moment, his last days in Hawaii. And our Lord, I guess, needed him more. I guess he had plans to show Shayne that Hawaii wasn't paradise and those weren't the beaches that he was looking for. I'm gonna miss my brother, but at least I know when I'm down and I look out at the ocean, his spirit always be with them.
I'm Armin, brother Raheem Caldwell. And I met Shayne around the end of seventh grade. We met Shayne around the end of seventh grade going into the summertime. And eventually, short after, I ended up going to East Hartford for the ninth grade. And I didn't know anybody there, but surely I seen Shane and I was the only person I knew and I was so happy to see him. And he showed me around and helped us integrate. And because of Shane, me and my brother, we didn't feel out of place, alone or awkward. And we went through the whole wanna be Mr. Smooth phase, trying to be the cool guy during our mid-teens, but towards the end of his teenage years, when I started seeing him making more mature business moves towards his career, I started to fuel off of his passion that he had to be a better businessman. And that right there is part of the reason why I myself started going to college, pursuing a degree at 21. And thank you. And during our whole 20s, up until this year in our 30s, every time we got up, we talked, it was always about business, trying to plan some sort of small business conglomerate or whatever you want to call it, if it wasn't health or wellness. And Shayne was that friend that was like just passionate about seeing his friend's progress. And he treated us just like as if we was his family, and it felt like it. He was that irreplaceable friend that was full of life, that even when I seen him down, he would always snap back to his upbeat personality. And that was just great strength to me to always see that through life, somebody to be able to do that. He was able to deal with all walks of life. So when I seen him get into real estate, I seen how that fit in to his personality of being real, real adaptive. And I seen plenty of opportunity for him in that field. Like I said, he was a super passionate person about what he did. I used to look at Hawaii like a place of a vacation. But now I look at Hawaii as a place to me that's kind of sacred in my mind. A place that was my friend's last destination. And I'm pretty sure You all will always remember him for being the same way. And forever, I will always remember Shayne forever. Thank you.
To the video tributes at this time. Video tributes by Jack Gagne and John Lee.
Shayne, you are my best friend. I wish you didn't leave us. I'm glad you're happy. Taught us all to always be happy and not take anything too seriously, to love life. You had no hatred in your heart. You were one of the most loyal people I ever met. We're all gonna miss you so much. We love you. And we know that you're still alive in your children. And in our hearts. And you'd want us all to be very happy. To be joyful and to celebrate who you are and who you were. And the great inspiration you've been to us all. We're gonna miss you dearly. I wish I could be there to celebrate your life with your family. God bless you all. And Shayne, God bless you. I'll never have another friend like you. Thank you for everything. And I know we'll see each other again.
Aloha, you guys. Good evening. Out here, Waikiki Beach. Just want to start by saying that Shayne is a very powerful individual, very focused, one of the most driven, focused people I ever came across in my entire life. And Shayne was a teacher to me. I learned a lot from Shayne, through Shayne. And I just want to start by saying something real quick, that the way we think about death in Hawaii, we don't think of it as a death. We think of it as a new beginning. That's why we don't ever say goodbye in Hawaii. We say ahui ho, which means until we meet again, because we we'll meet again. And our goal right now is to carry out Shayne's legacy, fulfill the dreams that he wanted to see, start being better people, and take care of one another in every way we can. And I want to tell everybody, you guys are all welcome out here to Hawaii. You can get my number from Carol, and I look forward to seeing you guys. You're all welcome here. And Shayne will be missed very deeply. Love you all.
We can tell he was a friend who loved very deeply and loved very much. And his impact was not only felt by friends in the broader sense, but also by even our city of Hartford. And to that end, we do have a special proclamation coming from the city of Hartford at this time. We invite Elder Helen Nixon to come forward and share that proclamation from the city of Hartford. And that will be followed by a resolution of respect that will be read following this proclamation.
Good afternoon. Okay. God has said, weeping may endure for the night, but joy comes in the morning. Amen. Praise the Lord. So to Cal and family and friends, I'm here to read some tributes from the state of Connecticut and the city of Hartford. Shayne was so well liked. I mean, this young man, like Matt Ritter says from the state of Connecticut, with a man with no limits to his talents. So we thank God for Shayne. When I think about Shayne, I think about my grandson who was laying right there approximately 3 years ago, Chase Hernandez. Shayne and Chase were the best of friends. He always kept in touch with my family, no matter when we had things at our house, he was there. In fact, just about a year ago, he was there. And he never forgot where he came from. And I just liked the way he was. He made sure that he stayed in touch with my family. And with Brinson and Paul Cameron and that group, they all were close. So thank God for you. Just remember, we all have to go that way and just keep holding on, keep waiting. And God said that he would be with us to the end. So my first, and like I said, Shayne was so popular. He was just all over the state, all over the city, and then he had the nerve to go to Hawaii trying to spread the gospel. So thank God for Shayne. So my first proclamation, the first tribute is gonna come from the state of Connecticut. General Assembly in memoriam. Be hereby known to all that the Connecticut House of Representatives extends its sincerest condolences and expression of sympathy to the Fields family on the passing of Shayne Ma Fields, a beloved son, father, brother, friend, and member of our community. Mr. Fields' legacy will live on through his church, his advocacy in the greater Hartford area, and the impact he had on others. Shayne was a man of faith who believed in the best of people and looked to make a difference in every person he encountered. He spent his life working to protect our environment, to bring joy to his community, and to strengthen the bonds of our city and our state. He was brave, generous, kind, strong, and full of purpose and passion. May the memory of his spirit and commitment to others live in our hearts forever. Introduced by Representative Matthew Ritter, First District, Speaker of the House. Given this 19th day of September, 2021, Matt Ritter, Speaker of the House, Denise Mario, Secretary of State. Okay. And my second tribute is from the City of Hartford, Connecticut. It's a proclamation by the Honorable Luke Broner, Mayor. And he did call Cal this morning because he was on the way to Washington. He wanted to talk to her before the film started. So this is a proclamation by the Honorable Luke Broner, Mayor. And it reads, Whereas Shayne Lamar Fields was born on August 31st, 1988 in Hartford, Connecticut to Carol Marjorie Clark Montague and Donnie Fields. And whereas Shayne Lamar Fields grew up in Greater Hartford and graduated top of his class from Weaver High School in 2006, and then attended both the University of Connecticut and Atlantic Union College. And whereas Shayne Lamar Fields was a devout and active member of Seventh-day Adventist Church in Hartford, a brilliant, talented, visionary with entrepreneurial skills, a creative mind, and a man with a good heart. And whereas Shayne Lamar Fields put his talent to use in many ways, in particular through his groundbreaking recycling company, which has several important clients in Hartford, Connecticut, before broadening his skill as a business person through his involvement in a wine company and then at a salon. And whereas Shayne Lamar Fields then pursued a career in the real estate industry, obtaining his license in 2017, earning induction into the National Association of Realtors, and serving on the boards of Mutual Housing, as well as the West Hartford Chamber of Commerce, before again following his spirit to fulfill his purpose in Hawaii. And whereas Shayne Lamar Fields found freedom, peace, and joy through his life, brightening the lives of his family and his friends and the community before tragically passing on August 30, 2021. Now, therefore, be it proclaimed that I, Luke Bronin, Mayor of the City of Hartford, along with the Court of Common Council and the citizens of Hartford, do hereby express our sincere condolences to Shayne Lamar Fields' mother, children, sisters, and all of his friends and family on his passing. In testimony of this proclamation, I hereby set my hand and cause the seal of the City of Hartford to be affixed the 19th day of September, 2021. Signed, Luke Bronner, Mayor, City of Hartford. Thank you.
Thank you, Elder Nixon, for sharing those citations. And we have a special resolution of respect coming to us from the Mount Zion African Methodist Episcopal Church, located at 601 Washington Street, Hastings, Florida. It's from the Reverend Johnny Johns, who is pastor, and it reads thus. Resolution of respect for Mr. Shayne Fields, September 2021. Jesus said, love the Lord your God with all your heart, all your soul, and all your mind. This is the first and most important commandment. The second is like the first. Love your neighbor as you love yourself. Inasmuch as Mr. Shayne Fields is the grandson of Sister Thelma Fields Neal, who is a loyal member of Mount Zion AME Church of Hastings, Florida, we feel it proper to send this resolution. Whereas our Heavenly Father in his wisdom has removed Mr. Shayne Fields from this earthly world, We know that his presence will be greatly missed by his loved ones, and that they give thanks to Almighty God for the privilege of allowing Shayne to spend time among them. It is our prayer that the family will accept their loss with God's will for calling him home. Each of us has an appointment on our unique journey. It is an appointment that no one can resist. We will ultimately walk this journey alone if we do not accept Christ as our Lord and Savior. Resolved that the pastor, officers, and members of the Mount Zion Amy Church extend their deepest sympathy to Shane's grandmother, Sister Thelma Neal, Shane's mother, and the entire family. May they rely on God, encourage one another to not get sidetracked, and to stay on the right path, as we all must do, because God's path leads to a glorious place. Resolved lastly, that a copy of this resolution will be given to the family of Mr. Shayne Fields and a copy placed in our church records. Prayerfully submitted, Reverend Johnny Johns, pastor, Reverend Porter Jr., local deacon, Sister Dorothy S. Edwards, secretary. Amen. Now I know the hour is fast spent and it's going really quickly, but we wanted to give an opportunity for two or three individuals to come forward and share a memory or a tribute of Shayne. Just two or three, and we're going to have to limit those comments to just 2 minutes per person. If there are two or three individuals who are desirous of sharing a memory, a tribute, or a recollection of Shayne, we invite you to come to the front at this time and we will receive those tributes. Is there anyone? Taking? Going once. Okay, my brother, that's one. Do we have two more? All right. Well, we'll go, we'll take this one, and then we will proceed with the program.
I'm Darryl Fields. I'm Shayne's nephew. I'm sorry. I'm his uncle. Can you hear me? Oh, the mask. I'll take it off. Okay. So I tried to be quiet as much as I could. Shayne, I knew his mother when she and my brother met. And Shayne was just like his dad. But here's the thing. Shayne had the energy exponentially of his father. He had an energy that could not be quelled. He was in a rush. And half the time I spent with him, I was trying to put the brakes on. I just wanted him to be a little patient. For the things that he had worked for, sometimes when you plant the seed, you can't rush to bloom. You have to sit and let nature take hold. You have to allow the plant to bloom. For me, this leaves a very, very big void. And it's not the kind of void that you think. For most of Shayne's life, he was focusing his energy in a way that wasn't really conducive to his future. And so one day we had this conversation, and one of the things that he could do with me, I explained early on, I said, Shayne, I'm not your father. I'm your uncle. What you do that's right or wrong, I can't control that. But as your uncle, I love you and I want you to be safe. And what you choose, I want you to be good at. So he told me some stories, like the auntie said. And he could tell you some things that would just shake you to the core. And I listened. And the way, what was so impressive was the way he articulated. And I said, Shayne, you know, I think you're missing your calling. And he's like, Uncle, what is that? You want me to preach? I said, well, I think you can. But I think that you'll be an outstanding real estate agent. And he did. So for me, the deals that he had on the table, the quality of his ambition, the fact that it didn't completely bloom for him, leaves a void. I see Rev has started to stand up. I got one more thing to tell you about this ambition. Shayne is the only person I know who could run in the dark at full speed. What I mean by that is, he could run at full speed and not see anything in front of him. But he was determined to make it wherever it was as fast as possible. So, I got a house in Delaware. Shayne comes down to the house. So, you know, we're doing some work in the house. And so Shayne takes the project of the doors. So about halfway through this project, taking off the doors, we're rehanging the doors, putting the hardware back on. I was like, Shayne, you ever done this before? No. No, I've never done it before. I was like, well, Shayne, how do you know? It's got to be easy, yeah. Right? You took the door off, you just put the door back.
My God.
God bless him.
Yes.
Okay? I love him as much as anyone could, and I'm going to miss him. Amen.
Amen. Amen.
Well, you know that. Thank you, Uncle. That needed to be said. That needed to be shared. Because of the time constraints we have for getting to the cemetery, we're going to have to proceed. But I'm sure there'll be an opportunity for others to share graveside, some of their memories and recollections at that time. Thank you so much for sharing. Praise the Lord. All right, now we are moving on with an item of musical praise. Chosen will be coming up to share a special item. After that, we will have a life sketch of Shayne shared by his cousins, Deja, Deanna, and Destiny, followed by a PowerPoint presentation of his life. So at this time, Chosen will come forward, followed by the life sketch, and then...
Thank you. afternoon, everyone. My sisters and I, we will be presenting the life sketch of our beloved cousin, Shayne. Shayne Lamar Fields was born on August 31st, 1988 in Hartford, Connecticut, to Carol Marjorie Clark Montague and Donnie Fields. He died tragically on Sunday, August 30th, 2021 in Hawaii. Shayne was a loving son, father, brother, and friend. He had a positive effect on everyone whom he came in contact. Shayne graduated from Hartford Area SDA School in 2002. He attended the International Baccalaureate Academy in East Hartford and later transferred to Weaver High School in Hartford, where he graduated top of his class in 2006. He attended the University of Connecticut in 2006 with a major in business administration and completed 1 year. He then decided to pursue his own business as an entrepreneur. In 2010, he desired to improve himself and pursue Christian education once again, so he enrolled in Atlantic Union College and ended that year with a GPA of 3.5. Shayne attended the Faith SDA Church, where he was an active member. He was a member of the Golden Eagle Pathfinder Club and actively participated in the Drum Corps. Shayne was a junior deacon. He sang tenor in G-Clef and Genesis Choir. He also played basketball for the Faith Knights. Shayne was a brilliant and talented young man. He took piano lessons as a child and mastered Beethoven in just a few lessons. He taught himself to play the bass guitar and even taught himself to knit by watching a friend. Shayne was a very determined young man and a visionary. He knew what he needed to meet his goals and was willing to do whatever it took to be successful. His goals, vision, commitment, and dedication were far beyond the imaginable. With his brilliancy, in 2012, he developed and implemented a business plan to help restaurants, bars, and apartment complexes responsibly handle their glass, cardboard, and plastic waste. He named the business Magitech Recycling LLC. His clients included City Steam, Maine and Temple apartment complexes, and the Riverfront Recapture Program in the city of Hartford. Shayne had the knowledge and skills to work with individuals of diverse backgrounds and cultures. He focused especially on ex-offenders to help them earn a living wage with employment through his company. Through his recycling business, this well-mannered green technology entrepreneur added more value and strength to the Hartford community as he campaigned with the Connecticut Coalition for Environmental Justice, CCEJ, to promote more recycling and less incineration.
Shayne worked with members and legislators and Congress for improvement of the city and gave testimonial speeches at several coalition meetings representing CEEJ. He met the Director of Department of Environmental and Energy Protection, DEEP, and other esteemed members of the Resource Recovery Task Force. In 2015, Shayne was invited to a legislation meeting at City Hall, and his proposal allowed a new bill to be passed, which changed the price of glass. He also took part in the CT Challenge launched by the mayor of Hartford, which allowed him to get funding for his company. Due to unforeseen circumstances, his business began to struggle. Therefore, in 2015, he ventured in a new direction and was employed as the warehouse manager of the Missing Link Wine Company, 55 Degrees Wine Company. Shayne continued to dream big and spread his wings as he became the manager of Zen's Nail and Spa in 2016. Zen Spa had its best customer service during the time Shayne was employed there. The clients enjoyed his upbeat energy and welcoming attitude. As stated by Zen, the owner of the spa, at Christmas, Shayne was the Santa to everyone. He was always such a helpful individual, always caring. While employed at Zen Spa, he had a new vision which led him into real estate. In 2016, Shayne attended the National Real Estate Institute, and by 2017, he obtained his real estate license. Immediately after receiving his license, he became employed at Robert C. White & Company, located in North Haven, Connecticut, where he was property manager and real estate agent. That company was not enough for him. He wanted something bigger and better, so he joined the team with Executive Real Estate Company, located in Glastonbury in 2018. He still was not satisfied, so in 2017, he was hired at Nile Commercial Real Estate Company, located in West Hartford, where he was the only African-American broker consultant ever hired there. He was inducted into the National Association of Realtors, NAR, as well as the Mutual Housing Board of Directors, and sat on the board of the West Hartford Chambers of Commerce. Shayne became unsatisfied with those companies, so he sought out bigger and better dreams. He decided to launch his own entrepreneur company in 2020, which he called Fields & Fields, LLC, dedicated in memory of his father, Donnie Fields.
Shayne once again decided he wanted a change that would bring him success and further fulfill his purpose in life. One of his best friends extended an invitation to visit Hawaii, and he took the opportunity. He went to Hawaii, loved it, and while there, decided to make a difference. Shayne continued to think about his family while there and informed them of plans to buy land and build homes for them to escape to for peace and rest in the future. Shayne had the biggest heart and was loving. He was adventurous, fearless, brave, and strong. He accomplished goals and overcame obstacles that many could never endure. Shayne kept pushing and reaching for higher goals, no matter the roadblocks. Shayne loved nature and would tell all close contacts that he felt a special connection with God while in Hawaii. Rivers, woods, and the outdoors allowed Shayne to feel free and peaceful. Shayne found pleasure going to beaches, hiking in the woods, rock climbing, and surfing. He even dreamt of flying a plane. This dream became reality when, after only one lesson, he sent a video to his family of him in the cockpit flying a plane over the island of Hawaii. That day was one of the happiest days of his life. He was so proud, and his family was proud of him also. Let's take a moment to look at a video. God knew that Shayne fulfilled his purpose in life. Shayne found freedom, peace, and joy. He left a legacy of bravery, inspiration, strength, and love. Shayne is survived by his mother, Carol Clark Montague, children Shania Preston and Hope Fields, his sisters Shannon Fields and Carissa Montague, his brothers Kareev Montague and Evron Montague, grandmothers Olga Clark and Thelma Neal, grandfathers Lenford Clark and Ed Johnson, and a host of aunts, uncles, cousins, nieces, and friends. He is predeceased by his father, Donnie Fields, and stepfather, Everton Montague.
Sleep in peace, cuz you will forever be in our hearts. See you in the new Jerusalem.
We have one more video.
Thank you.
We invite Sister Delray Smith to come and share a few acknowledgments, cards that the family may have received.
Good afternoon, Faith Church. It's always great to be back home. I extend a welcome from my home church, Atlanta Belvedere 70 Adventist Church in Atlanta, Georgia. And I'm here, as the elder just said, to just read some cards of condolences that has been given to my sister. She received many cards, and unfortunately, we are not able to read all of them at this time, so we selected just a few because of the time constraint. Let me introduce myself once again. I am Del Ray Smith, the sister of Carol and the aunt of Shayne Lamar Fields. Just briefly to interject, Shayne, he was thought to be my son in the earlier years. You wouldn't see me without Shayne and his cousins. They grew up as brothers and sisters, so that would be Shamara, our oldest niece, Deja, my oldest daughter, Shayne, and Deanna. You wouldn't see one without the other when they were younger. He was always a handful, always knew more than you. As a child, he thought he knew more than everyone. I've even had the opportunity of having Shayne live with me for a little bit in Atlanta. He kept the house jumping at all times. Here recently, Shayne would call me up, he would say, "Hey, Auntie, how you doing? I want to come down and see you and my cousins." I says, "Sure, anytime, Shayne." I would ask Shayne, "So when you want to come?" "Oh, tomorrow." I said, "Shayne, how are you going to get here? "I'm going to drive, Auntie." "Shayne, that's almost 20 hours." "Oh, no problem, we got this." So he would call from time to time and just tell me he's going to show up. He did have the opportunity to come a few times over the last couple of years and, you know, spend some time with us for the weekend. It was always a short stay, but it always seemed like he was there a long time. So I'm going to miss my Shayne, miss his big hugs when I come up to see him over the holidays. And as my niece says, those hugs were always tight, suffocating, but we loved them. All right, so at this time, I'm going to share with you all a few of our condolence cards, and I'm going to get through them as quickly as I can. First one is from Paul Houghton and family, from the church, actually. "Your son lives on in your heart, in your family, in memories of all that you've shared. Sharing in your sorrow and hoping you will find comfort in the wonderful memories your son left behind. On behalf of our pastor, Dr. Nicardo Delahaye, and the Faith Church family, please accept our deepest and most heartfelt condolences for your loss. Our prayers and support are with you and the family. John 14, verses 2-3 reminds us that earth has no sorrow that heaven cannot heal. Be encouraged during this most difficult time. We love you. Pastor Nicardo Delahaye, his strength is perfect in our weakness." Paul Houghton. Next we have from the Sabbath School Department here at Faith, "May God, who sees your grieving heart and hears each tender prayer, be ever near to give you peace
and keep you in his care. This is from the Faith Sabbath School Department. This is from our members of our sister church, Charity, an expression of sympathy. This is a time for gathering all the best of a good life and holding it in the heart forever. With deepest sympathy to you and your family in this time of sorrow. This is from Elder and Sister McIntosh. We have a card from Lester and Sherelle Primus and family, asking God to hold you close. Losing a child is one of those times we suddenly find ourselves living a chapter in life we have never have chosen. So sorry for all you're doing to go, you're having to go through. May God comfort, hope, and unending love carry you moments by moments. And then we have from the Davis family, you're in our thoughts and prayers. We all share your sadness in losing someone so special, wishing you the blessings of peace and the comfort of warm memories now and in the time ahead. And almost finally, we have from Yvette and Terrence, with sincere sympathy in the loss of your son. Carolyn family, although we cannot take away the sorrow that you bear, may it always be a comfort to know that others care. May God always be with you to bring you joy in your sorrow, strength in your weakness, and hope for tomorrow. You are in our hearts and our prayers. And finally, these are condolences from Bermuda. Dear Carol and family, we grieve with you at the untimely death of Shayne, your dear son. He will fondly be remembered in our hearts forever. May God give us his peace, comfort, and strength during the time of sorrow. The Lord himself goes before you and will be with you. He will never leave you nor forsake you. Deuteronomy 31, verse 81. Lovely Grandma Smith, Uncle Derek from Bermuda. Thank you all so much. And may God continue to bless each and every one of you.
Thank you, Sister Delray. Well, we are privileged today to have in our midst an anointed man of God in the person of Dr. Walton H. Rose. Dr. Rose was a former pastor of this great church and had the privilege of pastoring Shayne during his tenure. And we know God has given him a special word of encouragement, of comfort, and admonition for us during this season of loss. As Dr. Rose comes, I pray that you will give him your undivided attention and that you will flank him on the left and right with your prayers. Just before he comes, we will have a special item of musical meditation from Brother Brentis Smith.
I hear a sound,
of a mighty rushing wind. And it's closer now than it's ever been. I can almost hear the trumpet. As Gabriel sounds the call, and oh, at the midnight cry. Signs of these old times, they're appearing everywhere. I can almost see the Father as he says, "Son, go and get my children." No. At the midnight cry, the bride of Christ will rise. Church, get ready when Jesus steps out on a cloud to call his children. Oh yeah, and the dead in Christ shall rise to meet him in the air. And then those that remain shall be quickly changed, quickly changed in a moment. No, at the midnight cry, we'll be going home. I look around me, I see prophecies fulfilled everywhere, in signs of these old times. They're appearing everywhere, Lord. And I can almost see the Father as he says, "Son, go and get my children." And yeah, no, at the midnight cry, the bride of Christ will rise when Jesus steps out, and on a cloud to call his children. Yeah, yeah. And the dead in Christ shall rise, rise to meet him in the air. Change in a moment. low at the midnight cry. No, at the midnight cry. Oh, when Jesus steps out on a cloud to call his children, and the dead in Christ shall rise to meet him in the air, and then those that remain shall be quickly changed in a moment. No, at the midnight cry. No, at the midnight cry. Oh, at the midnight cry. Oh, we'll be going home. We'll be going home, going home.
Midnight cry. We will be going home to Carol, Shania, Preston, Hope, family and friends. God understands the heartache, the hurt, and the pain that you're experiencing right now. However, it is reassuring to know that you can find comfort and consolation in Jesus, who is the hope of our salvation. If we could sum up the purpose for an occasion like this, I believe it could be encapsulated in the words found in Matthew 5 and verse 4. Blessed are they that mourn, for they shall be comforted. For God he is our refuge and strength, a very present help in trouble. And he has promised to be a bridge over troubled waters and a shelter in a time of storm. So even in the midst of grief and sorrow, there is no need to worry or fret, for Jesus knows all about our struggles, and he will guide till the day is done. There's not a friend like the lowly Jesus, no, not one. No, not one. Let us bow our heads in prayer. Our Heavenly Father, creator and sustainer of all life, we come to you because you are more ready to hear us than we are to pray. You know our needs before we ask. So come now and comfort our hearts that we may embrace your loving kindness and tender mercy. Help us to live as those who have the blessed hope of your soon return. And when our days are accomplished, enable us to go forth knowing that nothing in life or in death is able to separate us from the great love of Christ Jesus our Lord. Amen and amen. I would like for you to, as we look at the text, Titus 2 and verse 13, and it reads, looking for that blessed hope and the glorious appearing of the great God and our Savior, Jesus Christ. I just want to speak to you on the subject, the hurt, the help, and the hope. As I began to consider what to say on such a tragic occasion as this, it became apparent that we are not here to say goodbye to Shayne, but farewell until we meet on that beautiful shore. At times like this, many people ask why the tragedy, the pain, the grief? Why did God let this happen? I want you to know that it's not wrong to ask why. For on the cross, Jesus asked, my God, why have thou forsaken me? Jesus asked why, and he always did the right thing. But the problem is that many times we cannot find the answer to that question. Therefore, there's a better question might be, what should we do now? Family, right now, we need to trust God and to get closer to him. For I have learned in this life that God conceals his purpose. You must keep living on his promises. Let me repeat that. When God conceals his purpose, you must keep living on his promises. That's why David said in Psalm 27 and verse 5, for in the time of trouble, he shall hide me in his pavilion. In the secret of his tabernacle shall he hide me. He shall set me up upon a rock. This rock that I'm talking about is Jesus. Yes, he's the one. This rock is Jesus, the only one. Be very sure. Your anchor holds and grips the solid rock. Today we come face to face with two of the greatest mysteries of the universe, life and death. Jesus predicted in John 16:33 that in this world you're gonna find trouble. My friends, you don't have to go looking for trouble. Trouble will find you. In Job 1 and verse 1, it says, man that is born of a woman is of a few days and full of trouble. David, realizing how short life is, in Psalm 39 and verse 4 says, Lord, make me to know mine end and to measure my days, what it is that I may know how frail I am. When you have done everything, you know what to do and have said everything, you know what to say, we realize it's not enough because death forces us to acknowledge that our only help, our only hope is in the boundless arms of Jesus. At death, we come to the end of human knowledge, human power, human effort, and human comfort. Titus, recognizing the challenges of life with its ups and its downs, admonishes us in Titus 2:13, saying, looking for that blessed hope and the glorious appearing of the great God and our Savior Jesus Christ. In other words, a child of God is always looking and preparing for what God has in store for them in the future. That's why it says in 1 Corinthians 2 and verse 9, it says, eyes have not seen, ears have not heard, neither have entered into the hearts of men the things that God has gone to prepare for them. Family, today, we need not be discouraged and despondent about our present trials as other men who have no hope, because we are looking, come on somebody, we are looking for a city that's builder and maker is God. I'm so glad that death and the grave is not the end, because Jesus, God's only begotten Son, died on the cross for our redemption. My friend Satan and evil men did everything to keep Jesus in the tomb. But early on Sunday morning, Jesus got up from the grave and conquered death, hell, and the tomb. Hallelujah! He conquered. That's why the Apostle Paul says in 1 Corinthians 15:55 through 57, O death, where is thy sting? O grave, where is thy victory? The sting of death is sin, and the strength of sin is the law. But thanks be to God, which giveth us the victory through our Lord and our Savior, Jesus Christ. I don't know about you, but my Jesus is not dead. He's not dead, but he's alive. I'm so glad that he rose, and because he rose, because he lives, I can face tomorrow. Because Jesus lives, all fear is gone, because I know there's something that the Christian knows that the world cannot understand. We know that Jesus lives. I know who holds the future, and life is worth the living because he lives. I'm so glad that Shane knew his Savior lives. See, Shane was a young man. I still can see his face. 21 years ago, little boy running around. Come on, somebody. I see him that he was someone who loved life. He loved his family. He was a pathfinder, drum corps. He was involved. If you read his obituary, talk about his entrepreneurial spirit. He was a visionary. He loved life. He wanted to live. He wanted God to be in his life. He was a devoted father and friend. Carol Shayne dearly loved you, cherished, and he honored you, and he loved you so much. Shayne loved his church. And that's something I want to say to especially our young people today. That when it comes down to it, we have got to learn to love God and know God for yourself. You're not too young to die and to leave this world. You've got to love Jesus Christ. But Shayne loved his church. He was involved in singing in the choir Genesis. He was involved in so many things. But we thank God for his life and for his legacy. There was a distinguished characteristic about Shayne, and that he loved people. You see, he was a young man that he don't care where you came from. He would talk to you. He would laugh with you. You see, while it was a tragic, untimely death, it also should be an occasion for sorrow and sadness. But by virtue of Shayne's life that he led, it should be an occasion for happiness. In 1 Thessalonians 4 and verse 13, Paul wrote, "But I would not have you ignorant, brethren, concerning them which are asleep, that ye sorrow not as even as others that have no hope." In other words, we are looking. We are looking for something greater than this world has to offer. For Jesus can bring joy to our hearts, peace to our minds, rest to our bodies, strength to our hands, assurance to our souls, determination to our wills, and virtue to our lives if we continue to trust in him. There are three things that can give us hope to go through the vicissitudes of life. Firstly, we have hope because Jesus gives us peace of mind. In John 14 and verse 27, Jesus says, "Peace I leave with you, my peace." If you look at the text, it says "my," which is a possessive pronoun. He said, "My peace, not as the world giveth, give I unto you." A lot of people talking about peace, peace in Afghanistan, peace in the Middle East, peace. But what Jesus is saying is that there is a peace that passeth all understanding, and this world cannot give it to you. It's the same peace when Jesus was at the bottom of a boat and everybody was panicking on the boat. But Jesus woke up, got up, looked at the winds, and said, "Peace." God can give you that peace that pass on all understanding. "Not as the world giveth, give I unto you. Let not your hearts be troubled, neither let it be afraid." Family, only God can give us peace of mind today. He understands our loss. He understands your sorrow, your heartaches, your pain, and your loneliness. He knows, I said he knows, about the vacancy, the empty spaces in your heart and in your home. However, there are good memories about Shayne that can never be taken away from you. Shayne's contagious smile, the compassion he showed to his family and friends, and how he loved others in need. Those memories will always remain in your heart. So keep on keeping on and trusting God. Secondly, we have hope because Jesus can turn our sorrows into joy. When Jesus came to earth, he came not on vacation or as a sightseer or a tourist, but he came to save humanity from eternal death, hell, and the grave. He came to let us know that earth has no sorrow that heaven cannot heal. On the cross, he took our thirst and quenched it, our hunger and satisfied it, our shame and removed it, our trouble and cured it, our loss and returned it, our turmoil and calmed it, our anxiety and assured it, our burdens and lifted it, our trials and faced it, our curse and destroyed it, our weakness and strengthened it, our emptiness and filled it, our bondage and released it, our faults and forgave it, it and our corruption and purified it, and he found death and conquered it. What an awesome God we serve. You remember Job? He had 7 sons and 3 daughters, and in one day he lost everything. And besides all of the troubles, his body was covered with sores. And even his wife said, "Why don't you just curse God and die?" But Job understood that God was just testing him. And he said, "Yea, though he slay me, yet will I trust him." When God tests you, he's drawing you closer, Carol, to himself. You see, without a test, you can't have a testimony. That's why in the good times and in the bad times, we need to praise his name. We need to give the King of Kings, no matter what, give him all the praise today, for God is good. Thirdly, we have hope because Jesus Christ is coming back to this world again. Because Christ is soon to return, we are comforted daily by the Holy Spirit. Job 35 and verse 10 says that in the midst of our troubles, God will give you a song in the night. My friends, God will give you a song in the night season. Even in grief, don't lose your song. You may lose some good friends along the way, but don't lose your song. You may lose your parents or grandparents, but don't lose your song. You may lose a few choice relatives along the way, but don't lose your song. You may even lose some possessions that are near and dear to you, but don't lose your song. You may lose some battles on life battlefields, but don't lose your song. Your hope may waver, your joy may flicker, your faith may weaken, but don't lose your song, for there is a brighter day. There's a brighter day coming. In 1 Thessalonians 4, 16 and 17, it says, "For the Lord himself," I'm so glad that God is not going to be sending Gabriel. He's not going to be sending the 24 elders. He's not going to be sending Moses. Who he's going to be sending, he says, "The Lord himself shall descend from heaven with a shout, with the voice of the archangel, and with the trump of God, and the dead in Christ shall rise first." In Revelation 21, 1, 2, 4, John said that I saw a new heaven and I saw a new earth. He said, "I saw it." In other words, it's not a figment of his imagination. It wasn't that he had something wrong with him. He said, "I saw a new heaven and a new earth, the holy city, the new Jerusalem, coming down out of heaven prepared as a bride for her husband." In that place, it says that God shall wipe away all tears from their eyes. There'll be no more crying. There'll be no more pain. There'll be no more sorrow. No more cancer, no more surgery, no more diabetes, no more broken relationships. There'll be no more death, for death itself shall die. The story is told of a man who bought a beautiful Parker pen. The pen was functioning very well, until the owner discovered that it was damaged and he had gotten ink all over his white shirt. So he called the company and told them that the pen, told him that the pen was the warranty. So he should put the pen in the box and send it back to the manufacturer. Well, Shayne was like that good old pen, but his ink ran out. But the good news today is that Shayne is under warranty. That's why we're putting him back in the box and sending him to his maker. His maker is getting ready to make him brand new. I'm so glad that heaven is a place where graves would never open, gates never close, tempers never rise, problems never occur, eyes never dim, friends never part, jealousy never exists. Rejoicing never stops. Doubts never arise. Distance never limits. And heaven is a place where blessings never stop ceasing. In the morning, this mortal is going to put on immortality. In the morning, we shall be changed. Changed in a twinkling of an eye. In the morning, God shall wipe away all tears from our eyes. In the morning, there shall be no more death, neither sorrow nor pain. In the morning, weeping may endure for a night. In the morning, life without death, love without limits, safety without fear, abundance without need, blessings without a curse, this singing without sobbing, perfection without flaw, giving without greed, excitement without end, and worship without rush. In the morning, when Christ shall come. I don't know about you, but I want to be there. I want to see Shayne. I want to see him again. And we'll go over old times and how God has been good. The hymnologist writes, when the saints go marching in. Oh, when the saints go marching in. Lord, I want to be in that number. Oh, when the saints go marching in. Oh, when the saints go marching in. Oh, when the saints go marching in. Lord, I want to be in that number. When the saints go marching in. Oh, when Gabriel blows that golden horn, when Gabriel blows that golden horn, Lord, I want to be in that number when Gabriel blows that golden horn. Oh, when they go through those pearly gates, oh, when they go through those pearly gates, Lord, I want to be in that number when they go through those pearly gates. Y'all didn't hear me. Oh, when they crown him Lord of all. Oh, when they crown him Lord, Lord of all. Lord, I want to be here, he would say like Paul, I fought a good fight. I finished my course. I've kept it. Young people, keep it. I've kept the faith. Henceforth is laid up for me a crown of righteousness, which the righteous judge shall give me on that day, and not just to me, but for all those who love his appearing. So Shayne, sleep your. Sleep on. Take your rest now. And Shayne, I'll see you in the morning.
My. when the saints go marching in. We're going to adjust just ever so slightly, and at this time invite Pastor Dr. James Janssen to come and share a prayer of comfort. After the prayer of comfort, we will have the Pathfinders render their salute, after which we will bring Genesis on to close us out with their special item. Again, Pastor James Janssen, now followed by the Pathfinder salute, and then Genesis. Thank you.
Good afternoon, everyone. Sister Carol. Deepest condolences to you. I praise God for your strength, Sister Carol. And as I hear your cry, I know that there is nothing that anyone can say to truly take the pain away, and so we turn to the Lord. And so I invite us all to bow as we pray. God of all comfort and compassion, we dare to approach you in this season of apparent God-forsakenness and unimaginable loss. We dare to acknowledge and reaffirm our unwavering belief in your sovereignty. You are still in control. We dare to utter words of praise and thanksgiving in the midst of the storm of our grief and pain. We dare not ask for answers or explanations on this side of the chasm that separates us from the heavenly realm. We are perplexed by the absurdity and the utter madness of our loss. No answer, no explanation, and no meaning will make sense on this side of eternity. We are left to cry along with the hymn writer Charles Wesley, "Father, I stretch my hands to thee. No other help I know. If thou withdraw thyself from me, ah, whither shall I go?" And so for the family, I ask that you would hold them, God. Carry them, dry their tears. And as we were reminded in the message today, a day is coming in the morning when death itself shall die. But until then, Father, keep them in your hands. Until then, cover them with your grace. Until then, walk with them every step of the way. We thank you, Lord, in Jesus' name. Amen. God bless you.
We invite all past and present Pathfinders to stand at attention as this guard of honor is displayed. time, we invite Genesis to come forward and to close us in benediction. Following Genesis' rendition of their special item will be Pastor Dr. Stephen Williams. Thank you.
shall never, we shall never, ever grow old. When the battle is over, we shall wear, we shall wear a crown. When the battle is over, we shall wear in the new Jerusalem. Hey, when it's over, we shall wear, we shall wear a crown, we shall wear.
Your benediction on this service, your benediction on Shayne's life. We seek your guidance for this family and your presence during the difficult days ahead. Help us to remember as we plan to leave this place that even though we may leave, you never leave us. So you will be there by our side to console and to keep. Thank you for loving us. Thank you for loving Shayne. Thank you for loving his family, his children, his mother. Please manifest that love daily to them in the dark days ahead. We pray in Jesus' name. Amen.
Funeral director to come forward and give us directions on how to proceed from here to the cemetery.
At this time, we're going to get ready to proceed to the cemetery. Pallbearers, gentlemen that are serving as pallbearers, I need to have you stand over here. Shayne will be taken out of this door. The family and friends will exit from this door. We would ask that if you're going to the cemetery, go immediately to your cars because we need to get to the cemetery. Turn your lights on and make sure you have a tag. If you don't, we'll make sure that you get one. Once again, please go immediately to your cars after you leave the sanctuary if you're going to the cemetery. Pallbearers, you can wait right over here.
Let not your heart be troubled. Ye believe in God, believe also in me. In my Father's house are many mansions. If it were not so, I would have told you, then anyway. I go to prepare a place for you, and if I go to prepare a place for you, I will come again and receive you unto myself, that where I am,